Hey guys, how are you, Brother Ray? I'm gonna share with you something that I don't really do, but I did today, and it's proven to be beneficial. You can see by my face that my face looks like I just woke up, right? Well, I drove to the mall, and I got myself a massage, a full body and foot massage, and it costed me $70. Now, let me share something else. Today is basically hump day for me. Today's actually not even hump day. Today's equivalent to, you know, my Tuesday. Anyway, I work in a very physical workplace. There's a lot of movement, a lot of walking. I'm basically on my foot for anywhere from 8 to 10 hours. And it was very ideal for me, honestly, to get a massage today. When I do get a massage, which is about once a month, I do it on a weekend, on the day that I'm off. One moment. Let me put my seatbelt. So today today I did something unorthodox. I got a massage on the day that I work. Not to mention, I've been exercising, lifting weights, playing basketball, and my body was very sore to the point that I couldn't really exercise yesterday, and I want to exercise every day. That's my goal. I want to exercise every single day. You know, the days that I'm technically supposed to rest, I want to exercise a body part that is, you know, that I basically didn't exercise. So far, I feel like that plan has conflict because I was so sore yesterday and the day before. The day before, I exercised it and I got sore. And yesterday was a continuation of that soreness. And I basically couldn't exercise yesterday. Today I couldn't exercise either because I remained sore. So I went to the mall and I got myself a full body massage. And I read somewhere, you know, through exercising, you know, exercise guides and stuff like that, gurus, you know, that they actually, you know, I don't know who I heard, but this individual recommended that I do get a massage. If my muscles are sore, do get a massage because it'll actually help to alleviate that soreness faster, right? And it'll basically squeeze out the acid in the muscles or something like that, right? I'm not a fitness guru, so I can't really, you know, I can't explain to you eloquently what I gathered from wherever I got it from. So and I feel a difference. Yeah, I'm not really sore. I feel refreshed. I kind of look like I just got up from bed or something, right? I feel better. My foot feels better. My foot feels like it's stepping on clouds. Fluffy clouds. And I go to work in about 2 hours. I go to work. And I feel like, you know, like I'm in a pretty good, my body feels motivated to, like my body can go to work and I won't have a strenuous experience working, you know, due to the soreness. I don't feel the soreness like that. So the conclusion of this video is I recommend, based on my experience that I had today, that people do invest in getting massages. I got a massage last week. I got a massage this week. I'm going to try to get a massage every week for a month. And then get a massage bi-weekly. And, you know, eventually monthly. Or bi-weekly, right? It costs money, but if you calculate how much money you spend on unhealthy activities, like going out to eat, going out to drink, Starbucks, whatever, even just gas, you know, which is not unhealthy, but, you know, it does cost money, the same amount of money you would spend going to a massage place, a good one. And, you know, it cost me $70. I gave them $20 as a tip, so overall it costed me $90. But look, man, I mean, you know, like I said, God is number one. Number two is your health, right? So number three is money, and, you know, and family is number four. Because you need money in order to maintain your family. You need your health to make money, and you need God to basically maintain your health. When you focus on God, naturally you'll become healthier. And not focusing on God is actually unhealthy to begin with, and that would affect your health, which will affect your ability to make money, which will affect your ability to have a structured family. So all those things are connected, but health is number two. So if you want to, you know, you should invest money on your health. LeBron James spends $1 million a year on his health. Ask how many athletes are spending $1 million, or people in general, millionaires and billionaires, how many of them are spending $1 million on their body? They're not. They're spending $1 million on, you know, recreational activities, material things. They are spending $1 million or more in their business. You know, they'll buy $1 million watch, they'll buy $1 million car, but they will not spend $1 million on their health. So whatever money you make, consider devoting a portion of that income towards your health, you know. The easiest thing you can do, easier than getting a gym membership, is go get a massage, man. It's rewarding. It's good, and it is, you know, it's like, it feels good, and it's better for your body. So now, since I'm in this exercise routine, I will, you know, like I said, every month, every week, this month, then bi-weekly, and then monthly. But if I keep experiencing soreness in my body, I will consider getting a massage on the days that I'm sore. So, yeah, I'm gonna consider getting a massage on the days that I'm sore, and then, you know, then get back to the gym and keep going. So, as that's that, you know, getting a massage, you know, if you can get it on a hump day, like, you know, when you're working, your half of, you know, half of the work week, you get it on a hump day, you probably will be feeling refreshed enough to end your work week. So I'm gonna shoot at doing that, you know, if my schedule makes it available for me. If everything's in place, I will consider getting a massage on a hump day. So that's my advice. Yeah, focus on God, maintain your health. Don't be a hypocrite like me. Look, I'm drinking Starbucks. Focus on making money and having good relationships, you know? And, yeah, that's that. Okay? Have a good day.